Hello, so in our previous video, we talked about how to add data to our Firestore database. We talked about how to retrieve data from our database, and we talked about how to add a form to add a new food to our database. In this video, we're going to use the same form to update foods that already exist in our database. So in our current app here, I created a new screen. I created a food detail screen. So basically, in our flat list here, in our list item, in OnPress, we now navigate to a new food detail screen. And I've added this to my navigator here. So food detail here, just like before. So if we click on a food item here, you can see that we go to a food detail screen. So we have the title here, we have the edit button that I added here. Right now it does nothing, but we'll add something here in a minute. And we just have a text view divider for our list here. So if we have ingredients, then we show the flat list. If we have no sub ingredients, then we show none here. There's a bunch of styling here for this. If you want to look at the styling, it's in the Git repo link in the description. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go to our food form screen. And we're actually going to change the structure of our state here for the food. Instead of having sub ingredients and food name and category like this, we're going to have one object called food. And then we're going to pass in, we're just going to call it name. And that'll be set to an empty string. And then category, empty string. And actually, let's do null for this. Null category, null, and we'll put our sub ingredients into here. So we'll get rid of this, and we'll get rid of these two. So now we have a food object in our state, and we have a current sub ingredient in our state here. Now, what do we want to do with this? We want to add this to our food form. So we can put in food, and then this dot. State.food. And we have to refactor some of our stuff here. I noticed in the last video that I kept in something that we don't need. We don't need these two functions here because our form is holding the state for the name and category, so we can get rid of these functions here. So when we set our state and submit subingredients, since our subingredients is now inside of our food object, we need to change how this is done here. So before we mention that, we're adding a new ingredient to the state subingredient array by first unpacking it with the three dots, and then we're adding the ingredient. But now we need to do an extra step. Now we need to actually put that into the food object itself. So we're going to refactor this by saying food. Now we do previous state of our food. So we have to unpack it the same way that we did here. Because this food item contains subfields now, so we want to keep the name and category the same and just change the subingredient array. We do comma, and then actually this can go outside of the entire line here. Previous date dot food. Now we set our subingredients this way. So it's very similar to what we had before, like this part here is the same, but now we put this inside of our food object. So I hope that makes sense. If that doesn't, then definitely research spread operators in JavaScript. So now we have this, right? So we have food, ingredient array, submit subingredients, and we're passing the food to our food form. So there's something else that we want to do in this component. We want to use a lifecycle method called component didMount. So this gets called after the component mounts. So in here, we want to get the food from the previous screen, if we have a food, and we want to set the state of this food to that food, or to the food that we received from the previous screen. So we're doing this so we can set the initial values of our food form to be updated. We'll see what that means in a second. So we're going to do constant. We're going to call it current food. I'm going to say equals this dot props navigation. We're going to get our food from our navigation object. and dot get param, and we're just gonna call it food. Let's log this. And for now, we're just going to do this here. Let's go back to our food list. So as you can see here in the list item, we're already passing the food to the food detail. This is something I did before the video too. So we're doing it the same way that we've done in other places like here. So our food detail is getting a food object, and we are, let's go back here, and we are getting that food object here and our component did mount. So let's reload this. And we need to do one more thing. We need to implement our edit button logic. So let's go to our food detail screen. And we're getting the food object here too. So if we go back to our food form screen, we're passing the food here, this.state.food, but we're not actually setting that state yet. So let's come back here and we're going to do, sorry, let's go back here. And let's do if current food, and then we set the state, this.setState, and we can do, let's do previous state like normal, and we do food, previous state.food, and we do equals current food. So we're taking the food from the food list screen that we pass in when we press the button here, or press the item in the list, and we set that food item to our previous state here as soon as we do component did mount. So we only do that when we go to the food form screen from our edit button, but we haven't put that in our code yet. So let's go back to our food detail screen and go to the edit button here. So if you remember from our food list screen, we're passing the food item to our food detail. So let's go back to our food detail here. So we're going to copy and paste our line from our food list screen. So we're going to the food form, right? So we take this here, and we're going to copy this into here. So we're going to navigate to the food form, but now we're going to pass in a food object. And this is going to come from our navigation object too. So navigation dot get param, and then it's going to be food. This should work, but let's go to our food form screen here. And you can see that we're logging the current food here. So let's save this and reload. Let's go to our log here and let's clear this. And let's go to burger, and then let's go to edit. So food form 23 is where we are logging the food. So you can see our food item is here. So let's go back to our code. We're going to put in a new title here to let the user know that this form is doing something different than just adding a food. So we're going to say navigation.getPram. And then we're going to check if we have a food item or not. And if we do, then we say edit food. And if we don't have a food item, then we can safely say that we're going to add a new food. So let's save, reload. So now if we press the floating button here, it says new food. And if we go back and go to detail and then edit, it says edit food here. So that's working correctly. Oh, there's one more thing that I forgot to do. Let's go back to our food form screen. And we are keeping something that we don't need. We don't need this anymore. So let's get rid of this here. So now our food form is looking a lot cleaner here. And let's now actually implement our update food function in our API class here, or our API file here. So we want to create a function. Let's put it under add food. Let's do export function, and we're going to call it update food, and we're going to say food, and we're going to send it a callback. Let's call it update complete. Now we're going to do a little bit of the same thing that we did before, but it'll look slightly different. So You see here, when we add a food, we created a credit at field. So we don't really need that anymore, right? Because now we're updating a food. So I want to create a new field called updated at. So now we'll have a field in our food that is updated. So we can see when a food was created and we can see when a food is updated. So we could say, actually, we'll just copy and paste this because it's the same code. So the timestamp will be used for the updated at field. Let's copy and paste this too, because this is a little bit similar. So we do collection.foods, and we're not doing add, right? So Firebase has a few other options. There's a method called set that I like to use. So set is a way for you to actually update the entire object at one time. But there's also a method called update, which lets you update a single field in an object, but we're not going to do that in this video. We're just going to override the entire food object. So the thing about set is that it does not return anything here. So we need to get rid of this promise here. And we're still gonna have this here, but we don't have any data that comes back. This gets called if it's successful. So that's all you really need to know, because we have our food object here, right? So we can call update complete here, and we can just pass in our food object and it'll be exactly the same. And we can save. Okay, so that's pretty much it for our update food method here. Console.log, and then we can do console.log food. And we'll save this. So before we finish with this function here, there's something important that we need to do for this to work. We need to tell Firebase which food is actually getting updated. So it has to know which document is being updated. So we need to also append .doc and pass in some ID here. So we don't know the ID yet. Our food item only contains these fields here, but we need to have an ID in our app for it to be updated. So we're going to change something here in our snapshot for each loop here. We're pushing the new food item to our food list, but now we actually want to add more to this data here. So we're gonna create a constant food item and set it equal to doc.data. Now we're actually gonna add the ID to the food item in our app. We're gonna create a new field. So food dot, we're gonna call it ID, and we're gonna say equals. So the ID comes from the document itself. So the data contains the actual data that you're looking for, and the ID contains the ID of the document. So we can say dot or doc dot ID. And now we can push the food to the list like this using food item and food item. Okay. So we're doing this every time that we receive the foods. It's not really a big deal. We're just overriding the ID every time with the same ID. We could check it to make sure that it doesn't exist, but you can do that on your own. It's not a big deal for our app. We're just overriding it. So now we have our ID here. So now we actually want to put our ID into here. So we can do food.id. And as you can see in our previous list here, we don't have IDs here. So I'm going to actually remove all of these documents here. It sucks that we have to do that, because this should have been something that we did from the start if we already knew that we were going to update the food items. That's something that you would want to think about ahead of time before you release your app for the first time. If you need to actually update something, then that should be in your initial release of your app. But in our case, we're going through different things about Firebase step by step, so. Okay, so anyways, we're updating our foods like that. So when we add food, we don't need to have our ID here because it doesn't exist yet. So we add our food there, and when we receive our foods from Firebase, we add the ID to it, and then we push it to our list. So when we update our food, we set it with the ID of our food item that we are interested in. And that should result in our food being updated in the server and on the app itself. So there's a couple more steps that we need to take care of. We need to actually implement our update food, or we need to actually use our update food function in our app. So where do we actually want to use that at? We want to use that in our food form screen. So we need to do a few things with our food form screen to get this to work. First, let's actually import our update food method here. Let's go to our food form here. So when we come here to edit our foods, we want all of this data to already be populated beforehand, right? We need to set the value of our text inputs first to be the food object that we are currently trying to edit. So let's go down here to our map props to values. So this will actually change because now we're getting our props, potentially we're getting our props from the previous screen. Name and category might not be an empty string. So map props to values takes in a props, but we're going to destruct that and just use food. So this is the same as saying props and then using props.food here. So we're just gonna say food here. So we're getting the food from our props. So now we actually wanna say name is equal to food.name. So if we have a name for our food, then it will be that name, else it would be an empty string. Let's go back to our food form. I think we want to set this to an empty string. Let's do that. And this. Yeah, I think these want to be an empty string. Save. Let's go to our food form and food.category. Okay, so that takes care of that. So now we actually need to add a new flag here. There's a flag called enable reinitialize. This should be set to true. It's set to false by default. So what this does is it tells with format to reinitialize if it receives new props. So something to keep in mind, if you're adding default props to your form, then you need to add this line here. Very important because you might end up spending a while trying to debug while your fields are not being pre-populated. Okay, so now let's go down to handle submit. We need to refactor this a bit too. So I want to have a condition here for this. We have add food here, but sometimes we want to update the food. So we're going to add a condition here. I'm going to say if props.food.id. So we're going to check to see if the food has an ID or not. If the food item doesn't have an ID, then we know that it's a new food. If it does have an ID, then we know that it's an existing food. So there's different ways to do this, but I feel this is a good way to do it for our app. I'm gonna have else here. Oops. Let's handle our else here first. So if it's a new food, then we add this here. Yeah, let's get rid of that, put that here. And if you recall, we're adding our ingredient array to our sub-ingredients value here, but now we don't have that anymore. And our sub-ingredients is part of our food object. So we still have values.sub-ingredients, but now we do equals props.food because we're passing our food object here. And then we do .sub-ingredients. So this can go outside of our if-else block here because that will always be the case. In our food ID here, we also need to do something different. We need to add the ID to our values. So we need to do values.id equals props.food.id. So we also need to add our values.createdAt field. There's other ways to do this, but I'm just showing you a very basic way to update your food, props.food.createdAt. And then we can call our update food method here. We can pass in our values, which is our food object, with the name, category, subingredients, ID, and created at. We don't really care about the updated field because that will get updated, or that will get set in the API function itself. So values, and then we do props And we need to pass in a function here, but we don't actually have that yet. But let's just put it here for now. We're gonna call it on food updated. Our else block should be okay. And let's go back to our food form screen. So we need to add this function here. I'm gonna add it here instead of adding it to our food list because, well, you'll see why in a second. So let's do on food updated. And we're gonna get our food here. And let's log that for now. We actually don't wanna do anything with the food for this video. You can if you want to, but we're actually going to go back to our food list screen. So we're going to do this.props.navigation. We could do pop, but I'm going to do pop to top. So pop to top pops it to the first screen in the current stack, which in our case would be the food list screen. So if we go back to our app.js, the food list is our first screen here. So let's go back here, let's save, and let's see, I want to save our food API file here. So I hope this all makes sense. We're essentially using the same form for our edit food and our add food, but we're pre-populating the food object if we're trying to edit a food. So for our on food updated, we want to pass this to our food form. So let's go down here, we could do on food updated equals, and it'll be the function this dot on food updated. So this function already exists in this file, and this function on food, the food added callback exists in our food list screen. So there's many different ways to set up your architecture for your app. This is just one way that I'm doing it. So we pass in that to this. So let's actually test out what we have. So let's reload this. Let's go to our debugger here, and we need to add a new food. So let's add burger junk food. What, cheese? Add. Okay, so invalid attempt to spread non-iterable instance. So this is happening in the, let's see, let's go back up here in our food form. I see. Okay, so I made a mistake here. Our sub-ingredients is part of our food, so we need to do previous state.food.sub-ingredients. Okay, so we're adding the ingredient to that sub-ingredient array inside of our food object. So reload. And we can add burger, junk food, cheese. Let's go back here. So our grid list is not being updated. So let's see why that's the case. You can see that our values are here. We have our food and we have our sub-ingredients here, but it's not adding it to our grid list. So let's go back to our code here. So we have, see, so we didn't change it here, so we need to change our items prop here to props.food. And we're not using ingredient array, we're using sub-ingredients. So let's save this, reload, and add burger, cheese, burger, stew junk, cheese, add, and now you can see that it is here. Debugger here, and we'll do beef, and let's do tomato, add. Okay, so now here comes the important moment. Let's press submit, and now we have burger junk. Let's add one more just to have more than one thing. Let's do pizza, Italian, cheese, sauce, yeast, I guess. Let's add that. Submit. Okay, so now let's go to our burger here. Everything looks good so far. Let's go to edit. But we don't have our name and category, but we have our sub-ingredients here. So let's go to our code here. Okay, so we need to set the initial value for our text input. So that's actually really easy to do. So let's go to our text input here. Let's do, there's a field called values. It says the value to show for the text input. So do value. And then we're going to say props. Remember, we're passing the food to this. So props.food.name. And then we're gonna copy and paste this here and do category and save this. And you can see it here, but let's reload just to be sure. And let's go to burger and let's go to edit. And as you can see, we have our name and category here. So this is a great way to pre-populate data in your app. Let's go back here just to be sure that it's not here when you press the add button, okay? So if we go back here, let's now try to actually update the fields. Let's call this taco up. So there's something else here that we need to work on. We're not setting our state correctly in our food form. So let's go back to our food form here. Ah, okay, so we shouldn't be using props.food.name here because this will always be what we have before. So it's overriding whatever we type in there. So instead of using props.food.name, we should be using props.value.name because we're using the value from our actual formic list here. If you are wondering why your values are not being updated in your formic form, then make sure you're using the values, not the data from your props. So save this, property.name.undefined. Values. Reload, and let's go to our burger, let's go to edit, and now we can change our text. So let's go back to our debugger, and I want to put in a taco burger, for example, and let's do junk food. So actually, let's go to our Firebase. Let's see that our data is correct. So burger junk. So we're going to change it to taco burger and junk food. So let's actually add a sub ingredient too. So let's add fish just because. And now let's submit. So collection.set is not a function. So let's go back to our API here. Collection.set. So I put this in the wrong order too. So once again, this is another good tip. Whenever you need to do a Firebase operation based on a specific document, remember to have the document first before you do the operation. So .doc and then .set. So let's save, reload. Let's go to burger, edit. We're gonna call this taco burger, junk food, and we're gonna add fish. Let's press submit. We have no error, which is good. Our food form screen, we are logging our new food, junk food, taco burger. Let's go to our Firebase console. And you can see that we have category junk food, name taco burger. We have our ID in here and we have updated. So we have our updated at timestamp here. So that's very handy for your app if you want to let a user know when something was created and when that thing was also updated. So we don't have it actually adding it here automatically. We have to refresh. That's something that we can do in a later video. And you can see it's taco burger now. Taco burger, cheese, beef, tomato, fish. And yeah, so that's pretty much it for updating a food. There's a lot of things that I could account for that I'm not accounting for in this video, but I just wanted to kind of show you how to update an item. And if you want to use update, then we'll get to that in another video, I think. But for now, we're just setting the food, which is overriding the entire object. Yeah, I hope this makes sense. And we are well on our way to being pros with Firebase. So we have adding data complete. We have getting data from Firebase complete. And we have updating a object in our Firestore database complete. So yeah, stay tuned for the next video where we'll cover deleting a object from our database. And at a later time, we'll actually cover real-time updates which is a lot easier than it sounds in Firebase. So yeah, have a good day and happy coding.